Hello everybody, my name is Patrick Oatney and welcome back in another YouTube chess training video. And today, for the third time and for the last time, I will show some great examples of great Smyslov, Vasily Smyslov, and I hope that you will learn how to play better chess, how to understand chess positions, and I believe I will show some interesting typical chess plans, and these positions or these chess plans will help you to improve your chess. So welcome in this video and we can start the show. First example, you are white, and what do you think is in this typical position the best plan for white? Looks like it's so simple because there is only one open file. And of course is making sense to fight and to win this open file, but I will tell you, this open file unfortunately is not so important in this position as another thing. So maybe stop this video for a while, because it looks like this position is typical and should help you to play better chess, should help you to understand more chess, and I believe that this is the best way how to improve our chess. Just watch a great chess player of chess history and learn from them. And for this reason, Smyslov should be the really great teacher. So stop this video and think. And if you did, thank you very much for your effort. And I will tell you that in these positions looks like white should have advantage because his knight is stronger than a bishop on d7, but it's not so simple to win this game only because you have knight against a bishop in these types of positions. So what to play, how to make a plan? And once again, if you can split chessboard in two halves, and if you can ask yourself where do you think white is stronger, I do believe that you will tell me that here we have 4 pawns and black only 3 pawns. It's making sense to play chess or chess moves where we have more material, where we are stronger. Another plan, of course, is where we are stronger, we have to play. And it's making sense that it's not so good idea to play on the left side, because on the left side the black has more space. And I believe that if we will ask this question where we have more material, where we should have advantage, we know where to play. But how to build this plan, what to play here? And once again, I believe that you can understand, and you can tell me that this wing is weakness. There is no defenders and looks like we should make attack. But how we should make attack? So the first plan, I believe that this pawn should go to f4, one day f5, and of course f6, because we have here more material, we have here more pawns. So that's the best plan, just go to f5, f6. So looks like this knight is doing nothing. And what do you think what we can do with this knight? The first move is h3. And we wish to go knight to h2 and g4. And on g4 this knight will be a really strong knight. Then we should play f4, one day f5 and f6. And I hope that you will agree with me that this knight on g4 is really stronger than on f3, and it's going to make hard time for black because it's attacking on f6, h6, and it's a really strong piece. So another plan should be to go with this rook, maybe to b3. g3 or f3, and you can see that step by step our plan is there. We wish to attack black on the right side of the chessboard because we believe that we have there more material and we have the right to play there because we are stronger. Now watch the great game of Vasily Smyslov, because you know, best teacher often is the best player. So h3, we know why, and now we are going to h2. I believe that this move, bishop to h4, is not good. Of course, the first threat is here, and black should go to c2, but at least what's more important, black lost f5 square. If you are on d7, you can feel that still black should stop white on f5 somehow, but now looks like f4, f5, f6 should be really fast. So the first threat, of course, we have to do something with rook to c2, so we are going maybe rook to c1, and that's a really good idea to not allow our opponent to play everything what he wish to play, so why not. And now you can see that the difference between this bishop and this knight, it's bigger and bigger, because you know, strong piece is piece which is attacking something, but this bishop is only maybe it's trying to be active, but it's not active because it's very hard to imagine what this bishop will attack. But this knight should go to g4, and of course will be difficult piece for black. Now this move, I believe, is making sense because we are going to g3, and yes, maybe one day white will lose this pawn, but I hope you understand me that white is not playing for material. White is not playing for endgame because he wished to win the game in the middle game. And of course b5, going to g3, and you can see that now looks like really black has no defender. Black doesn't care about his safeness, and you know, now he went to h8, but maybe it's too late because f4, f5, f6, I believe is the game over. And after a5, f5 and f6, I believe that you should enjoy this game because it looks like, you know, white's plan is working, is strong, and is a good lesson to us how to understand this chess game, because you know, the game has only last two moves, and exactly here black resign. What's the difference between chess where you have a plan and you know all your pieces has the same goal, same wish and same dream, but you can see that black pieces has not the same plan, because one rook is here is defending, one rook is here is fighting over c file, which is not important in this game. This bishop wish to support this b pawn, but you know, it's very difficult to imagine that black's plan is okay, because if you have one piece defending, one attacking, one supporting and one doing nothing altogether, is a really bad plan. And for this reason I love this example, and I will show you this example once again, because it's a look like, no, it's a difficult position and it's not really simple to handle this position, but you know, it's good to remember that it's a good idea to split chessboards in two halves and to play where we have more material, where we have more army or bigger army, and that's the best way how to play this position. So without move f4, f5, f6, I don't believe that white should have advantage. With move f4, f5, f6, I believe that white should have a big advantage. And then all together, step by step, move by move, it's making sense to play this position like a Smyslov. So h3, we are making space for f4. Now we are going to g4. Of course, we are trying to watch move f6. We are going to g3, and you can see that now we have the feeling that white know what he wish to play. He wish to attack, and with move f4, f5, f6, black has to defend, but you know, more attacking moves, just going army into the right squares and right part of chessboard. At the end, it's game over. And beautiful example, and maybe the right time to go for another example. It's wide on move, and what do you think is the best plan in this position for white? You know, don't worry if you are not able to spot the winning plans. Don't worry if you are lost in this position, because I will tell you through, I was lost as well. But you know, with new experience, with idea how to play this position, how to handle this position, we are becoming a stronger and stronger chess player, because chess is about experience. And for this reason, another example from Vasily Smyslov. You know, Smyslov Ivanchuk looks like a good example, and I believe you will enjoy this diagram. So, what do you think is the best setup of White army in this position? You know, I believe that if we have dark squares bishop, we have to attack some dark squares in our opponent's territory. I do believe that the biggest target should be on g7, because you know, this should be target for us. So how to set up this position? So I believe that this diagonal should be our diagonal, because you know, the difference in this position is that we have dark squares bishops, and black has light squares bishops. So that means we should be stronger on dark squares, and black should be stronger on the light squares. But it's really difficult to imagine what black's bishop will attack. Maybe he should attack on g2, but you know, we wish to attack on g7, so I do believe that we will be faster. And how to set up this this position? So if we wish to attack on g7, the best moves are to go to c3, to go to e5, maybe d4, and to attack on g7. Then we should play f4, f5, maybe f6, and that sounds like a plan. So that sounds like a good example how to handle this position. And information from us from this position is that we have one bishop and opponent has another bishop. We have to be stronger in our dark squares, not light squares. So the plan should be there where we are stronger, and we are stronger on the dark squares. And for this reason, everything is making sense. And more you can have feeling that we know what we are playing. So we're going to block this pawn, that's important. We should see that this piece is lost of somewhere of nowhere, because you know, one piece on the left, one piece in the middle, one piece on the corner, you know, that doesn't look like black know what he's playing, and he's coming back and back. Don't worry, we are going to e3 and we know why. Maybe we are going to g3 and we should attack this pawn, because if this bishop, because if we will take bishop, they will have to take bishop with the pawn, and then we should attack on g7. Everything is really simple. If we have target and target is on g7, our plan should be to use all of our army to take everything what we have and just go for g7. And that's my advice, that's the plan, and that's the information from Vasily Smyslov game. So f4, f5 is a threat. And now white nearly won, because you know, it's a really big threat on g7. We should go in this direction. So after d4, it's not making big difference. We have more material and we should win the game. What's beautiful in this position that black should take rook on f7, and white is fine with this position, even if he will lose this rook. So that's another story, that white's advantage was so big that he doesn't care, or he doesn't mind through some material. And that's exactly here, because he took on e4, and after move f5 You can see that the first plan to play f5, f6 is so strong and is so cool that black has still difficulties, even he has more material. But, you know, if you have more material, you have to have good pieces. And I believe that this bishop is maybe stronger than this rook. If you can understand that the bishop on c3 is attacking, is playing a really good game, but bishop on b3 is playing nothing. That's a difference between two pieces, and different that even rook used to be stronger than bishop, but if our bishop is more active than rook, I believe that activity is really important and is making sense to play active moves. So maybe now black think that it's good time to exchange another piece, but still this advantage is so big that you know, black is lost. The first threat is to take on h6, another threat is to take on d5, another threat is to take on a5, and believe me that the best plan in our chess positions is to attack opponent weaknesses. And you know, black has so many weaknesses, so it's a really enjoy or joy to attack his weaknesses and take one by one. So we are taking one, thank you a lot. We are going to h4. Of course, we don't want to see move d4, so for this reason we are ready. And now we are going to g4. Another weakness is on g7. Threat is f6, so it's very hard to defend this pawn. And thank you very much. And now I believe that you understand that white is winning, because he has so many pawns going forward that even black has two rooks, it's not a big difference. And even here black put back some material, doesn't matter. This endgame is simply winning for white. And black Ivanchuk, great Ivanchuk resign. So once again, what was interesting or important in this position? At the first look, looks like maybe difficult position, or it looks like difficult position for to make a plan. Maybe should be like we should find a not best move, maybe improving move. But this position is a really good position to make a plan, to make a target, and to believe that if we know where black has weakness, we should attack his weakness and we should play, we should make a plan. So the best plan is play f4, f5, f6. And you can see that this is a dark square, dark square, dark square. So we should play dark square strategy. And I do believe that this setup is beautiful one. And I hope you will remember this setup, because this is a really beautiful setup. And you see that even great Ivanchuk has a problem to play this game if white is playing this plan. So then f4, and still f5 is so strong, and f6 is much more stronger. Even black is going to exchange. At the end, there is so many weaknesses, and we know it that the best plan is to attack opponent weaknesses. So not a difficult game, but for this reason it's really cool to know some good examples. And I do believe you should like this video. If you like this video, thank you very much for like, thank you very much for follow our YouTube chess channel, because I believe that we will improve everything everywhere, and you should be improving chess player with our videos. So another good example, you know, I was absolutely wrong. I thought that I should play something like c4, c5, d5. I thought that I should play something with f4, f5. But you know, everything was wrong, and I had a feeling that I don't understand what to play here. You know, for me it was like a difficult position for white. Even I understand that white has two bishops, should have advantage, but you know, how to play this position, and once again, how to find a weakness. And it's not so difficult if you know this example, or if you know where black has weaknesses. And
same story. Black has light square bishops, as we have, but black doesn't have dark square bishops, so that means dark squares in black's territory should be a weakness. So that's all dark squares, and I do believe you are able to find the bigger dark square weaknesses, and I will give you 2-3 seconds just to think about where black has dark square weaknesses, and I hope you agree with me that everything here is weak. So how to play this position? It's good to attack black's weakness. So one weakness is on h6, so our plan should be to go to d3, h3, h6, and maybe checkmate on h8. And looks so simple, looks like chess is a difficult game, but you should be very happy, or you should smile to ourselves or to yourself that, you know, this plan is so stupid, so simple, so cool, so strong, so amazing, and is still working. So we are going to d3 and nothing more than attack dark squares. And yes, maybe you can ask why black should not go to h6. Because we are playing to h3, and if black will take here, we are taking here, and it's game over in two moves from starting position. And you can see what's a threat to win a fight over dark squares. And for this reason, black went to d5, but we are going to h3. And now the last threat is to go maybe here, and then we can take on h6 and do checkmate on h3. Nothing else, so simple, you know, as I told you, so stupid, so great, so amazing, still a great plan, and is worth to remember this plan, is worth to know this video, and I hope you are improving chess players. So, okay, we took. Doesn't looks like too difficult for us, and now black should resign. Why? Because, you know, black maybe love to save his bishop, but of course, well done, black saved his bishop, but black lost his life. So I hope you see to take on h6, and then you see checkmate on h4, and don't be surprised that was exactly the main plan from the starting position. So check and checkmate. And if I'm coming back to the starting position, looks like it's a difficult to find a plan, but if you know this position, if you know what to play, I do believe you should remember, and one day this plan will help you. This plan will win your game, and you will not tell to yourself that this position is difficult position. You will tell to yourself that, great, I know how to play this position. Cool, I'm going to win this position, and I'm improving chess player. Thank you to Smyslov, and I hope that you are improving chess player. So another position is waiting for us, and you are white. And what do you think is the most important topic in this position? So stop this video for a while. Press follow to my YouTube chess channel, or press like, because you should like this video. And if you did, thank you very much. Now we are going for a solution. The biggest weakness is on d5, and if you know how to play against this weakness, it's really important two plans. The first step is to block this pawn. Second step is attack this pawn. So looks simple, and watch another Smyslov's game where he is going to block this pawn. Now he's going to attack this pawn, and maybe he wished to double rooks. Now h5, okay, take, and you can see that all of white pieces are attacking d5. That's exactly the plan, as you should play this dispositions, block and attack, but attack with all your pieces, and that's a different, and that's a difference between a really weak chess player and strong chess player, because strong chess player, if is going for attack, is going with all his pieces. And okay, after, yes, I hope you see that it's difficult to take now this pawn, because then will be a really good day for black. So be careful for any threats or something what is difficult for us to handle. Now we move it from check, and we are going to improve, you know, everything. And I do believe that this position is so bad for black that he's going to lose. He is going to lose in a beautiful way. So I hope now you will enjoy the last moves of this position after g4. You can see that this rook looks like is lost, but at the end is lost this piece. So check, and I hope you understand that black has no many options how to play this position than to take on f4. And now white went to g1. First threat is to checkmate on d2. Another threat is checkmate on h3. So, you know, if you have two threats, believe me that one threat will be working, and after h3 it's checkmate. Beautiful one, and amazing game from Vasily Smyslov. Another example where I'm really happy to have chance to learn from Smyslov and to remember some of his great plan. And I hope you have the same answer. So you are black, and what do you think is the best plan in this position if you are improving chess player? So if you are able to find the biggest white weakness, well done. I believe that you are a really important, or sorry, important, improving chess player. So biggest weakness is on h3. And now think how to make, or how to win this game, how to checkmate white on h3. And it's not difficult if you know this plan. This rook is going to h8, and this piece should go to g3. And if you are able to set up this position, once again, that sounds like plan. Once again, well done, you are a really improving chess player. And if even this is difficult for you, as it was difficult for me, don't worry. You have new experience, you know how to play these positions. You started well, you know where white has weakness. And, you know, that's the great first step for your chess improving. So, we are going to make checkmate, and I will show you if white will take on a5. It's a really amazing checkmate, because there is no big choice for white than take and take, and that's game over. For these reasons, white took knight, but you know, at the end it's not big different, because there is still bigger weakness. Black has more material, he has activity, he has plan, and even if he will go to endgame, he's winning. So okay, now it's your time, and this is maybe typical or a really strong plan. So I wish to stop this video here, and I wish that you will think about this position, how black should play this position. And it's a really strong plan to think that if you have more material to invest your material advantages for maybe the winning end game. And if you are able to see that if black will take on c4, then he will have two strong these pawns going forward, strong this piece, and this rook will be behind your material or behind everything what black has important. I believe that this endgame is simply winning endgame for black. So he took, he's going to attack weakness, he's going to improve or centralization, and he's going to c5, because on c5 he's taking d4 pawn. He should be the biggest supporter of these two pawns, and the last winning moves is rook to b8, a4, b3, b2, b1 with support of this piece. Once again, looks like great film or movie. Black has only two pieces, but all his army, all his two pieces are playing one plan. They are playing like one team. You know, they are on the right part of the chessboard. They know what they wish to see. They know how to win this game. And that sounds like a plan. That sounds like white should resign in this position. And yes, of course, white resign. You know, to know a plan, to know plan, to know weakness is the best way how to improve our chess. And another example, last example, you are white and not a difficult position. How do you think white will win this position? And it's important to win this file. It's really important at the first point of this plan to go to d5. And if you have this rook on d5, then you will own this file. Another plan will be to go a4, c4, c5, b5, a5, because why? You have here more material. As I hope you know from the first example, you are playing where you have more material, you are playing where you have more pawns, and where you believe you should have advantage. And I hope you agree with me that in these positions, on the left side, you have three pawns against two. That's making sense to play there. So once again, it looks like this game is simple. How white will win this game without difficulties. And you know, step by step, we understand all moves, we understand positions, we understand plans, and well done. This is really the best way how to improve our chess. Really learn from great chess players. In their game is everything. So to go to d5, and we are winning the fifth rank. You can see that this knight is really doing great job, because this knight blocked this f7 pawn, and even black has two pawns on the right side against our one, but our nine block him, so this advantage is really difficult for black to handle or to use it. But our advantage is waiting for our moves, and it's not so difficult now to go okay, h5, improving piece, and now c4, a4, b5, just go forward, and okay, now it's two white species, a white pawn against black's one, and looks like there is no question if white will win this game. It's only question when white will win this game, and it's happened exactly now, because two pawns against one is a really big advantage, and in this position it's no way how to stop one of them. And that's game over of this game. And once again, I do believe that this position is typical position, and you know, strong chess player should know it and should know how to play this position, because this is the best way how to improve our chess. We have more material, we are playing where we have more material, we know some typical plan, And well done. Chess then is only fun. It's not a difficult game, and that's the best way how to play our games, how to improve. And yes, we are at the end. So thank you very much for watching. I will show you this example once again and speak to yourself if you are able to find winning plans or best plans. And if yes, that's the signal that you improved. It's a signal that this video helped you to improve your chess, because you know, maybe at the first sight you was not sure what to play, but now you know what to play in this position. Even you know what to play in this position, and this is beautiful position, so I hope you remember. This position looks for me like, you know, difficult for white, but now I know exactly what to play, and I hope, I believe that you know the typical plan in this position for white. And of course, if yes, this video helped you to play better chess and you are improving chess player. This position is not difficult if you know what to play, and I do believe you are 100% sure what to play here. And here, where is the white's biggest weakness, then everything is simple. This position I believe was typical, and I'm 100% sure you know how to play. And we are at the end, so I wish to say you thank you very much for watching this video. I wish to say you thank you very much for your time. I wish you are improving chess player. I believe you will improve your chess, and I believe I will see you here next time. Thank you very much for watching. Enjoy chess, and I will see you back one day. Thank you. Bye bye.